specifically requests emergency use authorization for its COVID-19 antibody therapy. American pharmaceutical company Eli Lilly is requesting for emergency use authorization, or EUA. This EUA is for the company's experimental COVID-19 antibody-based treatment. The request has been sent to the U.S. Food and Drug Administration. The request was supported by additional details from the antibody trial programs. On October 7, the company announced the interim data on the combination antibody treatment. Patients who were diagnosed with mild or moderate COVID-19 received either monoclonal antibody, combination treatment, or placebo. The combination treatment involved two antibody drugs by Lilly. Overall, the combination reduced coronavirus loads, symptoms, and emergency room visits in patients. The drugs were LYCOV-555 and LYCOV-016, which contained antibodies that bind SARS-CoV-2 spike proteins. These drugs were administered in the outpatient setting. A total of 112 patients received 2,800 milligrams of each antibody drug, while 156 patients were given placebo shots of the same dose. The first significant drop in viral loads was confirmed on day 11. Most participants, including placebo patients, nearly had complete viral clearance by day 11. But the initial decrease in viral loads due to the combination treatment was on days 3 and 7. Investigators compared the number of patients with persistent high viral loads at day 7. The antibody group had 3% lower than the 20.8% of the placebo group. Also, no apparent resistance variants were observed in those who received the treatment. The rate of hospitalization and ER visits was 0.9% for the antibody group and 5.8% for the placebo group. The numbers represented a relative risk reduction of 84.5% for those who received the therapy. That relative risk reduction was similar to the monotherapy of LYCOV-555. Patients tolerated the combination treatment. No one developed serious adverse events associated with the drugs. While less serious events were found the same in the combination group, monotherapy group, and placebo group. The LYCOV-555 will be referred to as bamlanivimab, while the LYCOV-016 will be referred to as etesevimab. The former is composed of neutralizing immunoglobulin G1 antibody, which attaches directly to the spike protein. The latter is a recombinant monoclonal neutralizing antibody that binds to the spike protein's binding domain. The monoclonal antibody prevents the binding domain from attaching to the ACE2 receptor. Eli Lilly expects 50,000 doses of LYCOV-555 available in quarter 4 of 2020.